Hello and a very warm welcome to Malaysia, the second stop on the 2018 HSBC BWF Tour. We're in Kuala Lumpur for finals day at the Malaysian Masters. And if we see badminton as good as we saw yesterday in the semis, we're going to be in for a real treat. This is a Super 500 event. Here are the way all the events are divided in 2018. 27 of them in total, for your delight and delectation, all building up to the grand finals. That's in Guangzhou in December. But plenty to come before we get to there. Next week, we're in Indonesia. Immediately, we're off to India after that. Then a very short break before the European swing begins in Basel. Then Mülheim in Germany, Birmingham for the All England Open. Then we go down under to Auckland and Sydney, Australia. The grand old USA in the middle of June. And then back to the Far East for more action from Malaysia and Indonesia. And that's just the next few months. Let's see what we've got in store for you today. We kick off with an eagerly awaited mixed doubles final. The Hong Kong pairing of Tan Chun Man and Tsai Ying Suet have carried all before them so far. They'll be the favourites. In the women's doubles, it's youth against experience. The Chinese pair are both 20. The Danish, Camilla Ritajul and Christina Pedersen in their 30s. Should be fascinating. After that, we'll see the current world champion and world number one, Victor Axelsen, who takes on Kenta Nishimoto of Japan, unseeded, but in fantastic form this week. Then, it's the women's singles final. Two of the best in the world, Tai Zhu Ying, the world number one, against the always great to watch, Ratchanok Intanon from Thailand. And finally, it's the men's doubles, the local hopes, Gobi Shem and Tan Wee Keong. It'll bring the house down if they win in the battle of the non-seeds. Well, our first match is going to be the mixed doubles final. And here's how the draw panned out. You can see the number one seeds were dumped out in the quarters and they were beaten by the Chinese pair who've made it all the way, the fifth seeds, Zheng Zui and Huang Keong. They are the fifth seeds up against the second seeds from Hong Kong. Well, a huge ovation for the Chinese pair within the Axiata Arena. It's got a capacity of around 14,500, a very good crowd in here, as we had yesterday, and plenty of support for these two, as you can see. And their opponents from Hong Kong, Tan Chun Man, Tsai Ying Suet, who have played so well for the whole of this week. Won the Danish Open last year. An up-and-coming pairing. They are ranked seventh in the world, and that is the highest they have been. So let's go down courtside for the toss.
This side. Reserve or receive?
Well, you saw on that head-to-head that we put up that Zheng and Huang have a 2-0 lead against the Hong Kong pairing, although probably fair to say that Tan Chun Man and Tsai Ying Suet playing as well now as they ever have done as a pair. The same, two golds at the World Junior Championships a couple of years ago. That was in the boys and the mixed doubles. In fact, we've got another gold in the mixed team event as well. Rank two, have been. Miss Wang, five mixed doubles titles last year, including the World Super Series in Dubai, plus Hong Kong, Malaysia, Australia, and China. They lost to today's opponents in the final in Denmark, and then beat them in Dubai. That's a path of their progress. They did three games in the first round. Since then, it's been pretty much plain sailing. I think they might get a tougher test today. Current form suggests that will be the case anyway. So, Tangchun Men. He's also ranked 27 in men's doubles, as well as 7, as you can see there, in the mixed. This pair won the Chinese Taipei Masters a couple of years ago. That was their first big win as a pair. And Tse Ying Suet there has been in superb form all week. She was a very accomplished, and still is, women's doubles player. She won the Japan Open women's doubles way back when. And was the runner-up in the women's doubles here last year, so she may well have a score to settle. They were taken to three games in the semis by the number 8 seeds. Other than that, pretty smooth progress so far. Chenier, the service judge here.
Okay, are you ready? Stop.
Here's the introductions. We'll be in a minute, once the players are ready.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Tangchun Men and Tse Ying Suet, Hong Kong, China. And on my left, Sheng Ziwei and Wang Jiaqiao, China. Sheng Suet to serve. Sheng Ziwei, level play.
So here we go. The first of 5 finals we're bringing you today.
One love.
Hong Kong pairing in the red.
And just in it. One love. Correction. Out. Sorry.
Well, everyone's nervous, one, including the umpire. Point for the Chinese, the server's out. Big money on offer today. First prize in this doubles event. Just over $27,500 US. Just over $13,000 for the runners up. Already a bit of a net battle developing between Tse Suet and Huang Kyung. Kind of speed around the court and reflexes that have so impressed this week, particularly from the female half of this partnership. Already it seems that both pairs try and take the initiative. I'm not sure we'll see lots of 50 or 60 shot rallies. Might be wrong, we'll see. Yeah, got in a great position on the film to make the kill there. Anticipated perfectly exactly what Tangchun Men was going to do. We won't be too pleased with it. All the way into the space.
Good
time to think about it, but still needed executing. Well, a misjudgment apparently. They are going to challenge it. So the first time that we're going to see Hawkeye in use today. He's called in. Wow. it was out by a country mile. Each pair have two challenges per game, and if they're correct, as in that case, they won't lose one. So still two for each pair. Well, that time he tried to get too much angle. Closed the racket face too much into the net. Very subtle. We've got two of the best net players in the game here in mixed doubles. It is going to be fascinating. Nothing in it. No challenge that time.
6-5.
Been away. Hakeem has served into the net. So 6-6 now.
Serves over 7-6.
He's made so few mistakes thus far this week. Turns for it.
7-7-0.
It's hardly been more than a point in it either way so far. Every indication this could be close. Misjudgment by Wang. She kind of smiled at her partner afterwards. I think she thought she could get to that. And he kind of stopped. It was over her racket. There was a challenge, however. Just out by a whisker.
Challenge unsuccessful. One challenge remaining. Service over.
Someone in the crowd with some kind of a flash on the camera. I'm told to please desist.
It's over. 8-7. Play.
Wow, just a little bit too eager.
9-7.
Crowds around with great effect at the back of the court.
Then,
terrific jump smash. And too hot for Singing Suet to handle. Might be a few nerves around. We've had a few service errors already. There was another one. Oh, it's clearly catching.
9-10.
Razor sharp. Seeing to it.
10-0.
Blink of an eye, she was onto this. Statutory hand of apology because it hit the body of her opponent, but no problem.
11-10.
Very, very close as we go for the interval.
Yeah.
very, very fit as well. Just 7 minutes, the first 21 points. Didn't think it was a match where we were going to see really long exchanges. And so far, absolutely nothing to choose between them. It's just been a pair that settles better. So far, we've seen a lot of service errors. Well, it's a potent weapon, isn't it? Wasn't quite deep enough. Pang was able to take that from, well, just beyond mid-court. Well advised to get out of the way there. Partner was all over that. Fascinating. It's been a mixture of slip winners and also plenty of unforced errors. Still just a point between them. Well, she did brilliantly saying search to retrieve that at one point, but same wouldn't be denied. 30. Oh. Refreshing, it's the first change of the shuffle we've had. We've had no one off for a towel break. Yes, we've only played for 10 minutes. Crowd have got pretty divided loyalties here, I think. Just want to see an entertaining, exciting game. That's what we've got so far. Is that the first error he's made, I think? Service fault. As if we needed any more drama in what's building up to be a... Yeah, it was above waist tight. Good spot. So just caught in two minds. Maybe just stab it or lift it. And it was way long that. Like being a close finish this opening game on finals day. Just a smidgen of daylight for the Hong Kong pair here. There's that predatory net instinct again. Number 16, 18. just when you thought one pair was in the ascendancy, it all changes. Still a slender lead. Well, initially it was Sei Ying Su who made the error, now it's a partner, and now we're all locked up again. Who's going to blink first here? Four points in a row now. And all the way very effectively to the back of the court. Again, Tang Chunman probably will think he didn't do enough with that. Just put the Hong Kong pair on the back foot at the moment. Just long. And here are a couple of game points. Goes Ray and Huang. One save emphatically. Now, pressure here on the Tang Chunman serve. I'm going to try and pick it off here. And then it goes, and that's the first game, 21-19, in double quick time. It was 14 minutes it took. Well, very refreshing to see both pairs back on court before the 2 minutes has expired.
Second game, love all, play.
Just missed the outside tram line. One, love. Good lead because he was slightly unbalanced. Chen there. One. They've only played each other twice previously. Last time did go to three games. We know from that first game they're pretty closely matched. Unlucky, but it's tremendous retrieving from the Hong Kong pair.
Service over. 2-1.
Can't understand how we didn't win the point. That was the reaction, and that one from Sei Ying Suet. Yeah. Well, if she managed to play that from on the ground, then you'd have seen everything. Hugely entertaining rally. It doesn't have to be a 50-stroker to be enthralling and fascinating and great entertainment. She threw a despairing racket at it just in case. I love the fact she plays with a smile, So Ying Sui. To all. Not going to toss away points.
Three.
In such a casual manner as that. In the second game, which is, again, you would imagine, likely to be close. Power of tension, man. It's about one of the first he's landed. It's resulted in a winner and hasn't come back. Tall man. Jump smash is a very effective weapon. Tension man, and it was summarily dealt with. Again, an apology. And the ball was hit at Tanchun there, but I'm sure with that. Trying to hit the shuttlecock rather down. Well, he's dangerous from the back of the court. He's even more dangerous from that position. And again, nip and tuck in the second game. Yeah, good instincts to let that go. Shuttle always heading wide. Time of asking. First time there's even been a 2-point gap in this game. Well, at the moment, Zhang and Huan can't handle the power of tension. Manolo smashes from, well, pretty much anywhere on the court. Deja vu. Two in red here. How hard do they have to work to win that point? Jerry with a capital V. Great touch again from Huang. Exploited that over the net, forced the error. What a pity, they've just won 3 points in a row, but they go for the interval with that service error. And it's 11-9 in favour of Tang Chinman and Se Ying Swat. Might be a critical misjudgment. He's all gearing up to play that as well. Might be ruining the fact he didn't. Judgments returning the serve. Just got themselves a little bit of momentum at the moment. Great retrieving at the back of the court from Huang. Most of the crowd thought there's going to be another Tang Chinman winner. Not the case. Well, now they're right back in this, just a point in it. That's close, doesn't it? Who has the initiative? Strange lead. She must have just lost her bearings. Was that? I think it was in the middle of the tram lines where the shuttle landed. Well, maybe not in the middle, but it was well in. between them and got it right. That could have ended in all kinds of problems. Fortunately, they were both on the same wavelength. It did go long. And they're back within a point again. Excellent placement. Tang Chunman scampering. Just about got a racket to it, but not much more than that. Excellent at the net from Tang Chunman there. Had a little bit of a fortunate net cord, but he'll take all he can get when you're game down. And he's pulled her again. Don't think he needed a net cord that time. Finale to a game. I think the crowd now are on the Hong Kong pair's side just because they want to see this continue to a third game. Can't blame them. Service errors between them. And now, 18 all. It's going to get even more tense.
18 all.
How many more net cords at crucial moments? Also really smiling on the same set there. And here are two game points to level the match. Quickly onto that, Frank. That was a very nervy shot. She really snatched at that. See exasperation from the coach because just tried to steer it rather than play it in a confident manner. Wow, what a time! What a time for a service error like that. Now it's game point again. There's nerves everywhere at the moment. Even half an hour into the match. And there is the game with another error. 22-20, and we are going all the way in this Malaysia Masters mixed doubles final. So, one game to decide the winners of the Malaysia Masters mixed doubles. Very hard to say who the momentum's with. Maybe the Hong Kong pair, but it's been so tight the whole way through. $12 million of total prize money on offer. The HSBC WBF Tour for 2018. And effectively here, they're playing for a difference of around about $13,000. Well, she played the more difficult shot very well. Just miscued that into the net. To keep up with the service errors in this match. It's 7 or 8, I think, already between the two pairs. Good lead. Especially with all the tension out there, it's sometimes easy to get caught up in the adrenaline of a rally like that. Keep your focus as well out. Anticipated, right. Not for the first time, she's ended up on the deck, seeing to it. Pretty easy kill, in truth. To defend as she was falling backwards there. That's it. the strapping on that right knee, Huang. I think it's just precautionary. He's moved in a pretty sprightly fashion in this match so far. Extremely effective at the net. Here's another example. Across court, they were both almost side by sometime there at one point. Hong Kong players, look at this. Caught the line. Saying that Huang touched the net, Huang doesn't like it. Let's have a look. Yeah, she did. That's a really good call. No challenges, of course, for that. It's been the line decision. That was nailed. It's just reactions. Absolute lightning. Because it was a very good shot from Huang. Problem was, an even better one came back. Brilliant badminton, absolutely brilliant. And it couldn't be better poised, this final. One game all, 10 points all. They might need the upcoming interval after this. Just one more point and then they'll be off for a minute's rest. The Hong Kong pair, who have the slimmest advantage.
Play.
Watched that very carefully, watched it drop wide. The next 10 minutes or so, 10 or 15 minutes going to decide this title. And it's as much nerve as it is technique. I don't think stamina's going to come into it much because there have been such quick points already midway through the third game in less than three quarters of an hour so far. Pick a winner from here, 12 all now.
12. Oh.
Oh, it's in. Just reaction block, really. Right between 13. The tram lines. That will work. Well, it's punch and counter-punch at the moment. Say he was a big man, 5'9", 5'10". Saw the gap, there's going to be a challenge, but I think this is good. I think this is an excellent shot. Looked as though the shuffle was club on the line, but Hawkeye will effectively make the ultimate decision. Absolutely club on the line.
Challenge unsuccessful, one challenge remaining. It's over, 50-40.
Play. Lincoln coaching staff looking on with their side having a slight advantage here. Oh, between the leg shot, but to no avail from Zheng. 4 foot from here, did you?
15,
literally a cigarette paper between these two pairs today. Someone is going to take home the title and very soon. He looked a little edgy in the quarter-final tension, man. Missed a load of those overheads in the back of the court, but today's been much more solid. Little fortune with the net caught off the Se Ying Suet serve. stop them. Teng Chun Meng finished it off. 3 points away. Still plenty of fight though left in this Chinese pair. Well, usually she's pretty reliable from that kind of range. Pressure on here, 19-16. Wow, what a time! Above waist height. It's not going to get anywhere, it's not challengeable. I've got to say, it's another good decision. But, wow, timing is all. Play. Held their nerve in that rally. And after 50-odd minutes on court, Teng Chun Meng and Sei Yin Suet have championship points. Well, how quickly is Zhang onto that? That's it! And the expression tells you everything. 21-18. In the final game, it's a come-from-behind win, a bold showing from the Chinese pair, but I think they've been the best mixed doubles pair all week here. Teng Chun Meng, Sei Yin Suet.
19-21, 22-20, 21-18.
That was the moment. Double clenched fists from both. They're getting a really good ovation too. They win 19-21, 22-20, 21-18 in 52 minutes of hugely entertaining badminton. It's the first of our five finals today. Very, very worthy winners. Presentation is in a few minutes' time. Look at those smiles. Teng Chun Meng actually just threw a badminton racket up into the crowd. Normally it's just a shuffle they whack up there or a sweatband or something. Actually gave one of the fans a racket.
Ladies and gentlemen, victory ceremony.
So here come the four players for our first victory ceremony of the afternoon.
For the mixed doubles. With great pleasure, we now invite Miss Susan Yu, Head of Marketing, HSBC Bank Malaysia Berhad, to give away the medals and bouquet to the both runners-up and champion, accompanied by Yang Berbahagia, Dato' Ng Chin Chai, Honorary Secretary, Badminton Association of Malaysia, and Chairman of the Organizing Committee, to give away the mock check to the winners. Runners-up, Zheng Siwei, Wang Yachong, China.
So the gallant runners-up, they've had a very good week. The number five seeds.
Runners-up will receive medals and bouquet of flowers.
Get a check as well for $13,300.
Champion Tan Chun Man Chai Yun Sui, Hong Kong, China.
Best pairing all week. I don't think there's any question about that. And now they are the mixed doubles champions here at the Malaysia Masters, adding to their Danish Open title last year.
Champion will receive medals and a bouquet of flowers.
And there. Winner's
now
check,
invite
$27,650.
Yang Berbahagia, Dato' Ng Chin Chai, to give away the mock check to the winners.
I love the way they say mock checks. You can walk into a bank and try and cash one of those. Confirmation of the amounts there.
And
it's a nice payday in this
champion will receive
500 event.
Cash prize $27,650.
All the prize money is in US dollars. And the 2018 HSBC BWF Tour. So there'll be a chance for the photographers to click away, get some pictures of our new champions.
Thank you very much, Ms. Susan Yeo and Yang Berbahagia, Dato' Ng Chin Chai.